Hi, this is Emma from Emma's Baseline, and welcome to our Introduction to Film Cinematography unit. Today we'll be covering different camera distances. How close or far away something is filmed can dramatically change the mood in a scene. Camera distance or shot distance refers to the distance between the camera and the subject being shot. Obviously, these apply to both objects and people, but today we'll be focusing on how camera distance affects the human subjects that are being shot. A close-up is when the camera is close to whatever is being shot. In a close-up, the majority of the frame is taken up by the actor's face. Close-ups can work in a variety of ways, but are very useful if we want to be in tune with the emotions of a character because we can see every little change in their facial expressions. For example, in this scene in Parasite, the wealthy Mrs. Park is taking a phone call while Mr. Kim acts as her driver. Even though Mrs. Park is the one speaking in this scene, this close-up on Mr. Kim really focuses on him as a character and tunes us into his emotions. If we filmed from any further away, we may not see the subtle acting on the part of Sung Kang Ho, and we'd experience the scene much differently.
아 맞다. 자기 미니 쿠퍼니까 그냥 우리 차고 안에 그냥 우겨 넣어.
An extreme close-up is when the camera is really close to the subject being shot. These shots can be uncomfortable to watch as they feel very cramped. Extreme close-ups can really focus us in on what we should be looking at, such as eyes, mouths, or objects. For example, the very first shot in the television show Lost is an extreme close-up on Jack's eye. Jack has just woken up after a plane crash, so this extreme close-up makes us feel as disoriented as Jack is. This shot also helps us understand who the protagonist is. A long shot is when the camera is far away from whatever's being shot. In a long shot, we can see most, if not all, the actor's body. Long shots can be used to make a character feel more small and isolated, or can simply be a way to fit more subjects in the frame. For example, this scene in Mad Max Fury Road occurs when Furiosa receives some very distressing news. She steps away from the other members of her party and takes this moment to let her emotions loose in the desert. This long shot makes her feel very alone and lost during this painful moment. An extreme long shot is when the camera is very far away from whatever's being shot. In an extreme long shot, the subject often takes up a very small part of the screen. These shots often isolate our subject further, making them feel small in comparison with their surroundings. For example, the opening scene of The Thing starts with a helicopter circling a dog in the middle of Antarctica. By filming this subject with extreme long shots, it feels very small and isolated compared to the vastness of its surroundings. A medium shot is when the camera is not particularly close or far away from whatever's being shot. This medium shot. In a medium shot, we often see the actor's head, chest, and some of their torso. These shots aren't really isolating or cramped in any way. Medium shots in film have been established as a more neutral or objective distance in film language. If a medium shot leans a little closer to a close-up or a long shot, we can call them a medium close-up or a medium long shot. A medium close-up can be most of an actor's face, but could include their neck, shoulders, and chest.
On top of that, she didn't have Twitter in middle school, and we did. That made us different.
A medium long shot can include most of the subject's body, but may be cut off around the knees. Some films use a variety of camera distances to convey different things during one scene. Let's look at this example in The Impossible. In this scene, we see a tsunami approaching a family staying at a resort in Thailand. We start with a close-up of the mother who sees this piece of glass start to shake. This close-up allows us to cue into her emotions as we see the realization on her face that something strange is going on. Then we get a medium long shot of another couple reacting to the noise. Since this shot is more neutral, we understand that these are not the central characters we'll focus on in the film. Then we get a quick long shot of one of the son's reaction. Then we check back in with the mother with a medium close-up as she looks towards the sky. After a quick close-up of a lizard fleeing from danger, we get a long shot of the father and two of the sons, and then a long shot of the mother. Since we're moving from close-ups to long shots, we start to realize how hopeless the family is becoming in the face of impending danger. Then we get something between a long shot and an extreme long shot of the sun reacting to the wave coming over the buildings. This shows how small he is in comparison with the wave. Finally, we get an extreme long shot of the tsunami, showing how powerful and massive it is in comparison to the people and the buildings. By alternating camera distances, this scene balances between the emotions of the characters with the close-ups and the danger of their surroundings with the long shots. Try to think about why the filmmaker is choosing that camera distance and why. Are they using a close-up to cue us into the emotions of the characters? Or are they using a long shot to isolate the subject? Something as simple as how close or far away the camera is from the subject can change how we view a scene dramatically. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like and subscribe for more film studies content. If there's something you'd like me to cover in a future video, please leave it in the comments. Thanks, we'll see you next time.